Hi, this is Sue Painter with The Confident Marketer, and today I'm going to do a vlog about some really simple marketing mistakes that I commonly see people do. In this case, it was a Florida realtor, and he really wasted his time. And so I want to show you some pictures of what he did and how he could have corrected it and probably would have had a lot more opportunity to make a sale. So what was this realtor selling? Well, he was selling a piece of Florida waterfront property, which is always popular. This is a view out to the ocean from this waterfront property. It's in the neighborhood where my husband and I live part of the year. And so when you go to sell a property, you really have to think about who your target market is. Just like in any business, you have to really hone in and think about what you're selling from the eyes of the person who will be buying it. And so that's, I call that watching your target market. In this case, this realtor will probably have an out-of-state buyer. It could easily be an international buyer. That will be someone more than likely not familiar with the area. They don't know the listing realtor and they're in a hurry. A lot of people fly into Florida. They look at property over a matter of 2 or 3 days and they want to pick one and close on it before they have to fly back to where their primary home is. So these are the kinds of people who look for waterfront properties in Florida. It's rarely someone who already lives in the town. Not to say that it couldn't be, but it rarely is. So what this guy did was he sent a note out to those of us who already live in this neighborhood and said, please attend my open house at 9606 Valencia Cave in Palmasola Harbor. And so these are some of the mistakes he made. First of all, there's a typo. It's Valencia Cove, not Valencia Cave. In Palmasola Harbor, that doesn't tell an out-of-towner really what type of development that is. He should have said in Palmasola Harbor condominium so that they would know they are coming to look at a condominium development. Sunday, January the 6th from 1 to 3. And if you will notice, he talks about what the unit is and he talks about the pricing, but there is absolutely nothing in there that gives his name or any kind of contact information. It would be nice to have a picture of the front of this unit. It would be nice to have a picture of the realtor. So that was the first mistake that he made. And then let's look at the back of his invitation. Now, on the back, which people rarely turn to, he does have his picture and his name and phone number. But if you will look, you got to remember that most of these people are from out of state, and he does not even have the area code for his cell phone or his office phone. This guy is assuming a local person who knows where Palmasola is, what kind of development it is, and that it's a local number who will be calling him, and such. It's not the case. That's not his target market at all. He also does not have any email listed on there. He does not have anywhere to connect with him on social media. He does not even have, not only does he not have the area code, he doesn't have the international calling code, and probably 25 to 30% of his lookers will be international buyers. He also does not have a way for people to connect with him by Skype. So he's wasted a lot of time putting together this invitation to this open house, and he hasn't really used the real estate on the material to full advantage. And as you can see here, this is what caught my eye first. He has a cell phone number. Everybody uses area codes down here because everybody is from somewhere else. And I don't even know what the local area code is, and I live down here half the year. So it's just a real bad mistake to do that. It just shows that you have a small mind and you're looking and thinking only locally, and that's probably not 1 in 20 buyers on waterfront property in Florida is a local buyer. So he's just really missing his market. So what are some of the things you can do to be a marketing maven and really not make those kind of beginner mistakes, because those are beginner mistakes? First of all, always review your ads with your customer's eyes. Think about it from your customer's eyes. Don't assume familiarity. I see that all the time where people think that their customer is already going to know what they're talking about. Get an outsider to look at your advertising before you print it. Think broader than your local market. You may have buyers now. The world is such a small place. You may have buyers now who are not local people. Use as many ways to make contact as you possibly can. Some people will want to use a cell phone. Some people will want to contact you with Skype. Some people will want to find you on Facebook and see what other kind of listings you have. You're losing opportunity if you don't list all the ways to contact you. Draw a picture of your ideal client or customer to those you are asking for referrals. Help them think of someone. So this guy dropped these invitations around to those of us who already lived in the neighborhood, but he didn't say, I'm looking for an out-of-state buyer who wants a great piece of waterfront property for seasonal rental or to live here seasonally. Or he didn't say, do you know someone overseas who's looking to come and have a part-time home in Florida? If he would draw a picture of who he's looking for as his ideal referral, then it would help the neighbors think of who might be interested in such a property. For a product, use visuals as well as words. Visuals always help, even if it's a service, but especially for a product like a house. He should have used some of that white space on that invitation to have some little thumbnail pictures of the waterfront property, the front of it, the back looking to the ocean, that kind of thing. So those are some of the ways you can be a marketing maven and not make really beginner, newbie mistakes in your marketing materials. This is Sue Painter talking about simple marketing mistakes, how a Florida realtor wasted his time so that you won't waste yours. Until next time,